ओके, गुड मॉर्निंग.
मॉर्निंग सर।
जस्ट मिनट है. ओके, सो टुडे विल स्टार्ट अवर फोर्थ मॉड्यूल. कहते हैं ओके ओके. सो दिस इज अबाउट द इंडस्ट्रियल रिलेशंस, कम्युनिकेशन एक्सेट्रा. बेसिकली एनी एट द वेरियस काइंड्स ऑफ इंडस्ट्रियल रिलेशंस. How the industrial or the relation, there is a relationship among the employer employee, and also how it can be modified or how it affects the production process, and regarding the communication and all. Okay. So basically the industrial relations mainly represents the relationship. What all relationships there that exist between the employer and employee, that is the dealt in the industrial relations. So this is the mainly relationship. Between employer and employee. Employer and employee. This is the industrial relation. Now what happens is, if the relation, there should be a good relationship between the employer and employee. Employer nu parayumba endana, the person who gives the employment, and the employee is the one who does the employment or do the job. Okay, so suppose if the relationship is not good or something happened in the relationship, then what happens is, then if this relation is strained or anything occurs, then various kinds of disputes or industrial disputes will be occurring. Some sort of disputes, or it may affect the final work itself or the productivity also. It will be working affecting. So if the relationship is not a good one, then ultimately it will affect the production process. So what are the main objectives of industrial relations? So we'll see the key objectives of industrial relations. Okay, IR. What are the objectives? First one, first of all, in order to have a good relation, what are the interest or the requirements of the labor as well as that of the management, it should be safeguarded. So first one is to safeguard the interest of both the labor as well as management. So this is the first objective. That is, in order to safeguard the interest of both the labor and also the management. Second one, in order to or avoid the conflicts. If there is a good relation, then we can avoid many conflicts. So to avoid conflicts, to avoid conflicts, conflicts, and develop a harmonious relation. So this is the second objective. And third one, so by having the good relation, we will be able to achieve the or increase the productivity. That is to raise the productivity. Raise the productivity. Fourth one, to bring down the strikes, lockout, get out, etc. So usually if there is any problem in the relation or any problems, then it is a usual trend that there will be some strikes, lockout or garao, etc. So the final objective or the fourth objective is that to reduce this or prevent these things, that is strike, lockout, garao, etc. Okay, that is the fourth one, that is bring out, bring down strikes, strikes, lockouts, okay. These are the main objectives. Now we'll see the factors. What are the main factors which affect the industrial revolution? Sorry, industrial relations. These relations, there are certain factors which can affect the relation. How we these relations are affected, that you will see. That is factors. Factors affecting relation, industrial relations. First one, there are mainly three factors. That is, first of all, we can list it. That is institutional factor. Institutional factor, institutional factor, then comes the economical factor, and finally technological factor. So these are the three factors which affect the industrial relations. So first one, institutional factors. Institutional factors. So what are the institutional factors? That means the factors which relates with the institution, or suppose a policy, a new policy is implemented, then what happens in the institutional point of view? In that case, the some certain policies are implemented, and it may affect the effect, working of the labor, or the labor may not be accepting that policy. So there some conflicts occurs, or disparity in their objectives or ideas will be there, and there will be some disparity. So this kind of factors are termed as the institutional factors. Next is the economical factor. Economical factor means the factor which is dealing with the amount or money. So there will be some, if in case there is a disparity in the wages between the groups, or the ownership, type of ownership, individual nature of composition of the workforce. So everything that is related to money, this all comes into a factor. So due to these things, there will be some conflicts, and there it may affect the relationship between the employer and employee. And these are the economical factors. And finally, the technological factors. If some techniques or technology, they are adopting another technology, new technologies, and usually the workers will have some inertia, that is, they tend to do the same procedure or same technology or the old technology, and the new technology may not be acceptable for them. So there will be some conflict, there will be a chance of conflict. So this is the technological factor. So basically there are three factors for or which affect the relations, industrial relation. The first one is the institutional factor, then comes the economical factor, and finally the technological factors. Okay, now we will see the psychological attitudes to the work and also the working condition. What are the psychological attitude towards the work? So the employees will have certain attitude towards the work that may differ from worker to worker. So we will see what are the types of attitude or the psychological attitudes towards the work, or the psychological attitudes. Psychological attitude to work and working conditions. ഈ നമ്പറിൽ ഒന്ന് വിളിക്കണേ, മറ്റേ ഫോണിൽ, മറ്റേ ഇതാന്ന് തോന്നുന്നു, കൊറിയറാന്ന് തോന്നുന്നു. വർക്കിംഗ് കണ്ടീഷൻസ്, ഓക്കെ. So what is an attitude? And then attitude ennu parayumbam nammal paranju psychological attitude to the work and working conditions. So first one, what is the attitude? Attitude mainly means that it is a set of emotions, belief, or anything, any behavior towards a particular object or person, thing, anything. Appo oru പർട്ടിക്കുലർ ഒബ്ജക്റ്റ് അല്ലെങ്കിൽ പേഴ്സൺ അല്ലെങ്കിൽ ഒരു ഇവൻ്റ് അതിനോട് എങ്ങനെ ഒരു എംപ്ലോയിക്ക് എന്താണ് ഉള്ള ഇമോഷൻ അല്ലെങ്കിൽ ബിഹേവിയർ, അതിനകത്തോട്ട് കാണിക്കുന്ന ബിഹേവിയേഴ്സ്, അതിനെയാണ് നമ്മൾ പൊതുവെ എന്താ പറയുക, ആറ്റിറ്റ്യൂഡ് എന്ന് പറയാം. അപ്പോൾ ഈ ആറ്റിറ്റ്യൂഡ്, ഈ പർട്ടിക്കുലർ ആറ്റിറ്റ്യൂഡ് എങ്ങനെയാണ് പല രീതിയിൽ വരാം, അല്ലെങ്കിൽ അതിൻ്റെ ആറ്റിറ്റ്യൂഡ് ഇപ്പോൾ ഒരു നല്ല ആറ്റിറ്റ്യൂഡ് ആയിരിക്കണം എന്നില്ല. ഇപ്പോൾ സപ്പോസ് ഒരു ഇൻഡസ്ട്രിയിൽ വർക്ക് ചെയ്യുന്ന ഒരാൾ, അയാൾക്ക് പല ടൈപ്പ് ആറ്റിറ്റ്യൂഡ് വരാം. അയാൾക്ക് നല്ല രീതി വേണേൽ വർക്ക് ചെയ്യാം, അല്ലെങ്കിൽ അയാൾക്ക് തോന്നാം ഇത് തൻ്റെ സ്വന്തം ഇൻസ്റ്റിറ്റ്യൂഷനാണ്, ആ രീതിയിൽ വർക്ക് ചെയ്യാം, അല്ലെങ്കിൽ എന്താണ് ഇത് വല്ലവൻ്റെയാണ് ആ രീതിയിൽ വർക്ക് ചെയ്യാം. അപ്പോൾ അതൊക്കെ ദാറ്റ് വിൽ ബി ഡിപ്പെൻഡൻ്റ് ഓൺ സെർട്ടൺ ഫാക്ടേഴ്സ്. പല കാരണങ്ങൾ കാരണം അയാളുടെ ആറ്റിറ്റ്യൂഡ്, മെൻ്റൽ ആറ്റിറ്റ്യൂഡ് അല്ലെങ്കിൽ സൈക്കോളജിക്കൽ ആറ്റിറ്റ്യൂഡ് ചേഞ്ച് ചെയ്യാം. അപ്പോൾ അത് എങ്ങനെയൊക്കെയാണ് വരുന്നത് എന്നുള്ളത് നോക്കാം. ഫസ്റ്റ് വൺ, ദ വർക്കിംഗ് കണ്ടീഷൻ ഓഫ് ദ ഫിസിക്കൽ നേച്ചർ, വർക്കിംഗ് കണ്ടീഷൻസ് ഓഫ് ഫിസിക്കൽ നേച്ചർ. फिजिकल नेचर। वर्किंग कंडीशन ऑफ द फिजिकल नेचर, वर्किंग कंडीशन ऑफ फिजिकल नेचर എന്ന് പറയുമ്പോൾ ഫിസിക്കൽ ആയിട്ട് ഫിസിക്കൽ നേച്ചർ, വാട്ട് ഇസ് ദ ഫിസിക്കൽ നേച്ചർ? അപ്പം വർക്കിംഗ് കണ്ടീഷൻ, അപ്പോൾ സോ ദ എംപ്ലോയർ വർക്കിംഗ് ഇൻ എ പർട്ടിക്കുലർ ഇൻഡസ്ട്രി, സോ വാട്ട് ഓൾ വർക്കിംഗ് കണ്ടീഷൻസ് ദർ ഇൻ എ ഫിസിക്കൽ മാനർ, ദാറ്റ് ഈസ് ഫോർ എക്സാമ്പിൾ ഇലുമിനേഷൻ, നല്ല ലൈറ്റ് ഉണ്ടോ, വെളിച്ചത്തിലാണോ വർക്ക് ചെയ്യുന്നത്, ഓർ പ്രോപ്പർ വെന്റിലേഷൻ ഈസ് ദർ, എയർ കണ്ടീഷനിങ് ഈസ് ദർ, or any noise pollution is there, whether it, more heating is there. So depending on the working condition, if there is a improper working condition, means it will create fatigue, increase in fatigue, or increase in fatigue normally endana oru madippu undavum alle, increase in the fatigue, and ultimately it will affect the productivity or the output of or the product quality. So the product quality or in the output will be affected due to this working condition. If the working condition is good, means it will have a good or positive impact on the working or the output. So this is the first one. So the how the attitude may change, that is in this case, if the working condition is good, it will have, or the worker will have a positive attitude. If the working condition is bad, then he may have the negative attitude towards the working condition. So this is the working condition of physical nature. Now the next type is working condition related to time. Working condition related to time, related to time, that is usually if what happens if the operator or the employer employee have to work for long time, suppose 24 hours anyway, he may not be working. If 12 hours like we have heard in 12 and all, people are working more than 12 hours, so in that case also, what is the thing regarding the time? If the time of working or the time of working will be or is more, then it may result in a fatigue, operation fatigue. So or madipu undavo alle, so usually in India and all, we are fixing certain time, that is 8 hour per day, or in the case of a week, in a week there will be totally 40 hours will be working, that is 8 into 5, like that. If the time is set like that, then it may help in increasing their efficiency, or it may develop a positive attitude towards the work. Otherwise there will be a negative attitude, and also the certain rest pauses are given. Rest pause means the time for tea break and all, there will be some rest pauses between the working hours. So these are there in the second point, that is working condition related to time. And one more thing, that is working condition related to social situation. Social situation within which individual works. Within which individual works. So the working condition related to social situation. So the which is related to the society. So if the society, is there any problem in observing the society regarding to many cases, like the community, social welfare,
So acceptance of the company employees by the community. Work in the community, these all have a positive impact or the attitude or the change in attitude towards the work. So these are the key attitude towards the work, how the attitude of the or the psychological attitude of the employees towards any particular work or working condition is there. First one is working condition of the physical nature, then working condition related to time, and finally the working condition related to social situation within which the individual works. So these are the psychological attitudes. Now regarding the industrial fatigue, what is the industrial fatigue? Industrial fatigue. What is industrial fatigue? Fatigue nu parayumba ariya endana oru madippu eppol aayirikkum madippu thonuva ah this is mainly the reduction in the work or the worker in by endu undayirikkam due to the reduction in the pleasure ayinodulla oru thaalpariyam povu. അപ്പോൾ പല കാരണങ്ങളുമുണ്ട് അതിൻ്റെ താല്പര്യം പോവാം. എന്താണ് മെയിൻലി എന്താണ് ഒരേ റിപ്പീറ്റഡ് വർക്ക്സ് ഡ്യൂ ടു റിപ്പീറ്റഡ് വർക്ക്സ് ഓർ ഡ്യൂ ടു ദ ഡീഗ്രഡേഷൻ ഇൻ ദ റിലേഷൻ മെയിൻലി റിലേഷൻ അല്ലേ ഒരു എംപ്ലോയി എംപ്ലോയർ റിലേഷൻ മെയിൻറ്റെയിൻ ചെയ്യാതെ വരുന്നു. അപ്പോൾ അവർ എന്താണ് എംപ്ലോയറുടെ തലയിൽ കയറുന്ന അങ്ങനെയൊക്കെ ഉള്ള കുറേ പ്രശ്നങ്ങൾ വരുന്നു, അല്ലെങ്കിൽ ഓവർ ടൈം വർക്ക് ചെയ്യേണ്ടി വരുന്നു. അപ്പോൾ അങ്ങനെയൊക്കെ വരുമ്പോൾ എന്താണ് യൂഷ്വലി ദർ ബി എ ടെൻഡൻസി ടു ഹാവ് എ reduction in the efficiency of their working, that is termed as the fatigue. Appo adana fatigue nu parane ini namukku nokka endakkeyana ingane or industrial fatigue undavanulla cases or the factors which contributes to the industrial fatigue. So the factors factors which contribute to the industrial fatigue. Let's see. First one, the repetitive works. When the work is repetitive, usually the repeated works are there allotted, then usually they will have the tendency to have the fatigue, repetitive works or the repetition of the work. Second one, non recognition of the work of the employee by the employer. Adayid oru nalla reethiyil work cheyunu, suppose an employee is working very hard. And if the employer who gives the employment, he is not seeing that, adu manasilakkunnilla, appo angane varumba usually ayakku ullil oru madippu undavum alle. There is a non recognition of work of the employee by the employer. Then the working conditions, like the bad or unsafe working conditions. Bad or working unsafe working conditions, like if there is not proper lighting, or if unnecessary noise is there, or high temperatures working conditions. In that case, or unsafe working conditions, these conditions may create a fatigue.
And then next is the lack of cooperation of the co-workers. If the co-workers, the workers, if the colleagues, his colleagues are not cooperating, then usually there will be a tendency to have the fatigue or ഒരു മടുപ്പ് ഉണ്ടാവാൻ ചാൻസ് വരും അല്ലേ. There is a lack of cooperation. Lack of cooperation of the co-workers. That may also create the industrial fatigue. Then regarding the time, longer hours of work. If the time of working is more, we have already discussed, if the time of working is more, then usually there will be a tendency to have a fatigue. Then some personal reasons. Personal reason, like if there is any family problem for the employee, that will be reflected in his work. If there is any problem, anything may be there related to his personal life, and it will be there in his mind, and it will be ultimately affect in his work, and that may create a fatigue. Then next is the complexity of the production process. Complexity of the production process. If the process, what all production process is has undergone, if it is a complex, it is not at all simple, and it is complex, then it may usually have a tendency to create a fatigue. The eighth one, sometimes the workers, they are not properly placed depending on their skill level. Maybe some workers have high skill, they were placed in a low level, and sometimes the person without any skill will be placed in the higher position. പല കേസിലും അങ്ങനെയാണ്, പലയിടത്ത് നമുക്ക് നോക്കി അറിയാൻ പറ്റും. അതുപോലെ വെറും പൊട്ടനെ ആയിരിക്കും പിടിച്ചിട്ട് അതിൻ്റെ തലപ്പത്ത് വെച്ചേക്കുക. ചിലപ്പോൾ അതിൻ്റെ എന്താ പറയുക, അതിനുള്ള കഴിവുള്ള ആളുകളുണ്ടാവും, പക്ഷേ കറക്റ്റ് പ്രോപ്പർ പ്ലേസിങ് ആയിരിക്കില്ല ഉണ്ടാവുക. അങ്ങനെ വരുമ്പോൾ എന്തായിരിക്കും ഉണ്ടാവുക, അവിടെ ഫുള്ള് പ്രശ്നങ്ങളായിരിക്കും ഉണ്ടാവുക. അപ്പോൾ നമുക്ക് അങ്ങനെ കുറേ പ്രശ്നങ്ങൾ വരും. അപ്പോൾ അവിടെ വർക്ക് ചെയ്യുന്നവർക്കും എന്തായിരിക്കും, ഒരു മടുപ്പായിരിക്കും ഉണ്ടാവുക. ദാറ്റ് ഈസ് എ മെയിൻ തിങ് ഇൻ എനി ഇൻഡസ്ട്രി ഓർ എനിതിങ്. So there is the next one. There is the workers may not be properly placed. There is the workers may not be properly placed. And finally, one more thing regarding the ergonomics. Ergonomic aspect. There is the posture, sitting posture, or whether he's standing or bending for long period, anything. Appo nammude position enganaana irikkunnathu, allengil whether the environment, working environment, it is heat, ഹ്യൂജ് ഹീറ്റ് ഉള്ള സ്ഥലമാണോ, അല്ലെ, അങ്ങനെയൊക്കെ ഉള്ള, ദാറ്റ് ഈസ് ഡിപ്പെൻഡിങ് ഓൺ ദ മെഡിക്കൽ കേസസ്, അല്ലെങ്കിൽ ഇതേപോലുള്ള എർഗണോമിക് ആസ്പെക്ട്സ്, അതും ഒരു മെയിൻ ഫാക്ടറാണ് വിച്ച് കോൺട്രിബ്യൂട്ട്സ് ടു ദ ഇൻഡസ്ട്രിയൽ ഫാറ്റിക്. സോ ദീസ് ആർ ദ മെയിൻ ഫാക്ടേഴ്സ് വിച്ച് കോൺട്രിബ്യൂട്ട് ടു ഇൻഡസ്ട്രിയൽ ഫാറ്റിക്. ഫസ്റ്റ് വൺ,
repetitive works. Wherever there is a repetition of works, then there will be industrial fatigue. Second one, the non-recognition of work of the employee by the employer. Then due to bad or unsafe working conditions. Fourth one, lack of cooperation with the co-workers. Fifth one, longer hours of work. Then due to some personal reasons. And seventh one, due to the complexity of the production process. And eighth one, the workers may not be properly placed. And finally, the ergonomic aspects. So these